It is 9 minutes past three on Tuesday, the 10th of July. It started on the 23rd of June. That is when it was first reported that these 12 boys and their soccer coach had gone missing. They'd gone into this cave complex in Thailand, the biggest or the nearest big city, Chiang Rai, and they'd not come out. It was not a story that in the beginning I paid a great deal of attention to, partly because I didn't think it had anything other than a ghastly ending. And I did not want to spend a lot of time poring over international news reports, which told me nothing other than that the chances of these boys having died, and their coach having died, that was increasing in probability. And then came that extraordinary day when those two British divers found them. And they were alive, and they'd survived 9 days in those terrible conditions, in total darkness, with no food, just licking water dripping from seeps in the walls of the cave. And then we started to try to understand how difficult it was going to be to rescue them, and we tried to imagine ourselves into a situation where they might have to spend 3 or 4 months in those conditions. Yes, they would have communication. Yes, they would have food. Yes, they would have medical attention and so on. But still, the amount of psychological impact that that lengthy stay in those conditions would have, How do you wrap your head around that and the danger of a rescue attempt and the threat of monsoon rain and flooding the cave even further, and every day just constantly feeding myself with information about what was going on. And then the first group of four came out the day before yesterday. And then another four came out yesterday. And slowly, well, not slowly, by then, I allowed myself to believe that this thing would be successfully concluded. And today, the final four boys and the coach are out. We don't know yet what long-term impacts there might be on their physical health or on their psychological health, but given the enormous strength of character and marvelous temperament that has got them through to this point where fairly soon they will be reunited with their families, it's kind of, I think, persuasive that the psychological damage will be limited, absolutely limited. Physical, we don't know. I mean, it's just the most magnificent story.